Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are diving into standard notes. We're looking at the extended edition. That's the premium version of standard notes. We're going to be overviewing some of the features, some of the benefits, the pricing, as well as announcing a giveaway near the end of this video for you to win standard notes extensions. So guys, feel free to stay tuned for this video. I'm looking forward to diving into standard notes. So guys, as you can imagine, we reviewed Standard Notes a couple of weeks ago. It was great to actually dive into that application. I did compare it a lot to Evernote in that video, but again, I don't think it's that much of an Evernote competitor to some extent. It is a note taker. In essence, it will allow you to do the similar experience as a note taker, but the actual extended edition, which we're reviewing today, which is the premium edition, actually does feel a lot closer to Evernote than the basic version does. Now, just a little bit of a recap, it's available pretty much on every device. So you've got it on web, Mac, Windows, and iOS and Android. So you're gonna get it pretty much everywhere, which is great. And the application really focuses on privacy versus necessarily going much further in your sort of image experience, etc. Because obviously once you add attachments, it adds complexity to the encryption levels. Of course, you can still encrypt through there. And that's what some of the standard notes features does offer. So as you can imagine, we'll be reviewing the pro version today. We'll give you the pricing nearer the end. So let's dive in. So here we are. It looks probably a lot different to what you saw last time, mainly because this has a few of the extensions already installed. First thing I want to do is go down to the account in the left-hand corner. You can still access all of your information there. You've also got two new areas. The areas for password lock, so you can actually get the passcode lock using your actual device. So for example, if you wanted to lock it using there, you can do so. And also data backups, either encrypted or decrypted. You can download a backup to your desktop straight away and also import one. They also get sent to your email automatically as well. And if you want it to, it can even send to Dropbox, Google Drive, and OneDrive. Now there are a few, 27 to be specific, core extensions. They can be accessed down here. We'll be going through some of the ones that I've installed, some of the repository that's all accessible there. But as you can imagine, there's a range of themes and editors and actual components that you can install to improve your experience. Now, a few things that are notable is that it does have unlimited file attachment encryption, so you can upload directly into Dropbox, Google Drive, or web dev servers. You can also use some of the revision history to go back and restore versions, which is very accessible. And you've also got two-step authentication, which will be available for all of your devices, which is mad, I think, because once you add that layer, including the passcode and the encryption that you've already got, it will really add a huge level of security to your application. So let's start by talking a little bit about themes. I think themes are a great starting point. They're very basic, but as you can imagine, not as complex as some of the other stuff we'll be talking about. Here I've got the Midnight theme installed, and it does look a lot different to what it does in the Standard Notes Free edition we talked about. So you can click it and activate it here. These extensions are almost like Chrome extensions. You add them, and once you've got them, you can just play around with them. And you have to install them. That's something that is notable. So here are the themes. Here are the bonus themes down here. I've got Midnight installed, which is like a dark mode, but you can install other ones. So for example, this one's Focus. And if I click off, you can see Focus is sort of like a pinky purple and a good way to view it. So if you ever want to, you can uninstall them or you can activate them and obviously switch between the two. And each one, each time will be activated differently. Now, if I click Titanium, I wanted to install that. I can do that too. There are a couple more like Futura, Solarized Dark, Dynamic, which actually isn't a theme. It's part of the other element. Now, as you can imagine, those are some of the basic themes that you get, and you can switch between the two or three, depending on how many you want. But themes are broken into their own section, so that's really accessible. So moving on to the component side of stuff, I've installed a couple of components, the good starting points. You can see that extensions is already installed. That's something that allows you to access this page here, the repository. And you can see up here as well, I've got folders installed, so I can start beginning to create folders. If I deactivate that, it simply goes back to tags. But if I wanted to create folders again and coordinate that up there, I can do. I can use Cloud Link to encrypt some of the data that I've already got. either through note history, so I can install that one, and that has been successfully installed, or daily email backups, so that can be really easy, or anything that you back up can go to Dropbox, Google Drive, or OneDrive as well. You have to set them up separately. Now, if I wanted to, I could set up the quick tags as well, which I've already done. You can see at the top, the tags are accessible here. So if I wanted to add checklists really easily, so quick tags accessible up there. I can open a batch manager as well. So if I want to edit some actions that I've got running, which we'll demonstrate a bit later. Notes, so for example, I want to bulk delete some notes, I could easily do that. Or even bulk delete server extensions or components, themes, tags, and editors, which is really cool. Now, we're talking about editors. Editors really doubles up your experience and sort of makes it a bit more interactive. Now, what I think we covered previously, the editor looked very much like this. This was a plain editor. You couldn't get any more editors than that outside of it, but you can get tons of editors, and we'll be demoing a few here. So this is the plus editor. Looks a lot like Evernote. You can change the font, the size, all of the lovely stuff like bold, italic, as well as add an order list, as well as tables too. Tables are really easy to use as well. And of course, you can do all the sort of tabley stuff you would. You can upload pictures and videos as long as they're encrypted. And you can see all of the lovely stuff in sort of full bleed, which is really easy to do. Now, if you want to set that one as your default, you can. But you can switch to, for example, Markdown or Simple Task Editor. So for example, you could set a list here, and then if you wanted to turn them all into tasks, you could do so here. And you have open tasks and completed tasks here. So for example, if I completed that one, that would move down to completed. So it's a nice way to actually organize your actions and activities. But if I just wanted to keep it really simple, I'd go back to this view here. Now, editing still works very much the same, and you can do all of the lovely stuff that you want to. You can go to session history, and if you want to go back and actually go to the start of what we had, you can restore a copy or restore as a copy of that edition, which is very easy to do. Now, options, you can access options. If I just click off the session history, you can see that you can lock the page, you can delete it, and you can change the font too, as well as add spell check or check the margin resizes. So it's very advanced. Like, I would say this is more hacky than it is sort of like basic. So if you want to add any more editors, you could, for example, add a simple markdown editor, an advanced markdown editor, code editor, a simple task editor, which we demoed, minimal editor, fancy markdown editor, plus editor, which we got, Vim editor. Some of these I haven't heard of, and that's pretty much all you can access. And in terms of components that you can add, so we added quick tags, but you can add an action bar, which gives you the ability to see all of the information on the current note that you're working on. A GitHub push, we have the folders activated already, but you can also add a no distraction filter, so a theme that focuses only on the work at hand. Now, you have to install two-step authentication through the manager and the file storage, for example, Cloud Link, and through file safe. So this is where the encrypted files actually come in. You have to actually activate it through here. So I wouldn't really go for this editor if this was a go-to one. I think I'm much more comfortable with something a bit easier than this. But if it's something that you are very keen on and interested on, especially for some of the themes, I can see a lot of developers or programmers using this one, and especially a lot of the editing functions. If you move between editors like Advanced Markdown or Simple Markdown, you're gonna love this. Now, if you're wondering about pricing, this application doesn't come as cheap as you think. The monthly plan is $9.99 a month. If you're paying for it monthly, it's gonna really add up. But again, you can move to the yearly plan, which is $49.99, or the five-year plan, which is $149, equating to $2.58 per month. That's 75% off, apparently. According to the expanded package, they're able to offer a 100% refund within 30 days of your purchase if you try and decide it's not for you. Now, a couple of things I would like to notably mention about this application is it's available on all devices. The free package does include the AES-256 integration with encryption, which is great. And it has sync, web access, and offline. The experience is impressive if you're a basic user. So if you just want a simple note sort of experience, note ticket that's developed by WordPress, this is going to be the perfect experience for you. I would say it's much more personalized for developers, programmers, and markdown writers. And it's a really custom note taker that you'll, if you're willing to invest in it, then this is the application for you. So guys, that was my sort of outline of extensions. Hopefully it gave you a good idea of the application. I applaud you to check out their page. For anyone that would like to enter the giveaway, all you would have to do is hit the like button, comment with whether you're interested in this application, and also do share this video on social media for a bonus entry into this competition. We've got 5 one-year extensions, we've got 5 one-year extended packages to give away, very kindly offered by the team at Standard Notes. So feel free to enter. It'd be great to have you enter this competition, and we'll sort out the winners once a week or two has gone by. Anyway, guys, huge thank you for stopping by today. Hopefully this gave you all the information. I will give you all the information in the description so you can go away and enjoy that. Anyway, guys, make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.